we have been able to join us or not. Then other faculty members, dear students, and Dr. I think Surjan Singh has joined, and Madam Padra is also, Madam Kajal is there. So, as far as this today's proceedings are concerned, we have with us our student and faculty member, Madam Kamala, who took admission in 2015 and 16, and consuming so much time, so she has been almost ready to deliver her pre-thesis seminar, but now prior to this now, we have already conducted her department level seminar on 30th of April and the second time on 7th of May. Because on 30th of April, it was not possible for us to complete in a single day because of this network issue. Then it was postponed for another day, and on 7th of May it was completed at the department level. So as far as the today's our Dean Postgraduate Studies concerned, so he has conveyed the message to our Superintendent of Controller Office of Examination that now due to some technical problem in his laptop, so he has gone to the market. So but now he has asked us to kindly go ahead and get the seminar delivered. So, has Ajanath joined us? Ajanath, Dr. Ajanath? No, Madam Manu, have you sent the link to Dr. Ajanath?
Yes, sir. Unhone khudi send kiya.
Okay. So, anyhow, so I request Madam Kamala to kindly proceed ahead and deliver your pre-thesis seminar. Which has been notified in fact from the Dean Postgraduate side, though at the department level, Dr. S.H. Chal, though at the department level, we have given twice chance to Madam Kamala to present her thesis. So on 30th of April as well as on 7th of May, twice at that time, Madam Dhaliwal was present at that time. From again, she is at Ludhiana, Madam Dhaliwal is at Ludhiana, so she joined us from Ludhiana at that time and very say lengthy seminar. I mean, all the tables which she has prepared, all those are presented by her. Maybe say today she may be presenting some of the important results of the thesis. So, Madam Kamala, kindly proceed.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here today. I'm Kamala from Department of Economics. I'm here today for my thesis presentation on the topic Analytical Study on Human Labor Availability and its Utilization Segment in Punjab Agriculture under the guidance of Dr. S.K. Chauhan sir, and my advisory committee are Dr. S.S. Chahal, Dr. D.K. Sharma, Mrs. S.K. Dhaliwal and Dr. Kajal Chaudhary. The contents of my presentation are firstly, the introduction of the topic, then objective of the study, and material and method used, and result and discussion, then finally conclusion and policy implications. So, as we all know that agriculture labors constitute the largest segment of the workforce in India, and economic growth depends on the economic growth of India depends on the economic well-being of the agriculture laborers. According to the Rural Labor Enquiry Committee report, the number of rural households has increased by 8.44%, which was 150.2 million during 2004-05, and which increased to 162.8 million in 2009-10. And out of these 162.8 million rural households, 65.7 million were rural labor households and 41.7 million were agricultural labor households. So my study area is Punjab, and Punjab occupies very important place in Indian agriculture. According to the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, Punjab occupies about 1.5% of the total geographical area and 3% of the agriculture area. And as per 2011 census, the total population of Punjab is 2.77 crore, which consists of 2.29% of the total population of the country. About 2/3 of the state population live in rural area, and 36% of the population is dependent on agriculture and allied activities for its livelihood. According to the NABARD, Punjab agriculture is highly intensive in terms of land, capital, energy, nutrients, agriculture input, machinery, irrigation, and intensive farming community. These are the objectives of my study. Firstly, to examine the human labor availability in Punjab agriculture, then to study the factors affecting demand for human labor in Punjab agriculture, also to examine the extent of labor utilization pattern in different agricultural activities, and to work out the extent of casualization among agricultural labor force in Punjab. Also to examine the various social economic problems faced by the agricultural labor in Punjab, and finally to suggest the policy measures for mitigating problems faced by the human labor in Punjab agriculture. As my study area is Punjab, so Punjab is mainly divided into three agroclimatic zones, which is the central zone, submountainous zone, and southwestern zone. And sub-mountainous zone consists of Pathankot, Hoshiarpur, Nawansheher, Roopnagar, etc. And the central zone consists of Gurdaspur, Amritsar, Tarantaran, Kapurthala, Jalandhar, Ludhiana, Fatehgarh Sahib, etc. And the southwestern zone consists of Firozpur, Faridkot, Bathinda, Mansa, Barnala, and so on. So, these agroclimatic zones were named as Zone 1, Zone 2, and Zone 3, and multi-stage random sampling technique was used for the selection of the sample respondents. At the first stage, one district from each zone was selected randomly. So, from Zone 1, Roopnagar district, from Zone 2, Jalandhar district, and from Zone 3, Bathinda district was selected randomly. After the selection of district, next stage is the selection of blocks. So, two blocks from each district were selected randomly. So, from Roopnagar, Morinda, and Chamkaur Sahib block, from Jalandhar district, Adampur and Jalandhar East block, and from Bathinda, Bathinda and Maur block were selected randomly. After the selection of blocks, the next stage is the selection of villages. So, two villages from each block was selected randomly. From Morinda, Gopalpur and Sarhi village, from Chambar Sahib, Kalapur and Nidya village, from Adampur, Kutipur and Madar village, from Jalandhar East, Purampur and Talang village, from Bathinda, Baluana and Jodhpurwana village, and from Mall, Bhutisewa and Yatri village was selected randomly. After that, the next stage is the selection of sample respondents. So, 12 laborers and 12 farmers from each village were selected randomly. So, the total sample of 144 laborers and 144 farmers were selected randomly. And the data collected from 144 farmers in 12 villages were then plotted on a graph for examining the distribution based on land holding. And the data did not show much uniformity. Hence, it was decided to categorize them into three groups using square root cumulative frequency method. For this, the data were arranged in an ascending order and suitable number of intervals based on land holding. And in this way, the data was grouped as small, medium, and large, and the detail is given in table 3.2. And out of 144 cultivators, 45 were categorized as small, 69 were medium and 40 were categorized as large farmers. So in order to envisage the objective of the study, both primary as well as secondary data were collected, and the primary data were collected from village prominent knowledgeable persons, farmers and agricultural laborers through personal interview website, and secondary data were collected from state agriculture profile of Punjab and various issues of statistical extract of Punjab, also from Indian village directory and equal offices near the village and various research reports. For analytical framework, demographic and crop indices were worked out through these are the demographic and crop indices which are worked out. And first is the sex ratio, which was calculated through total population of the female over total population of male multiplied by 1000. And population density was calculated through total number of people over land area in square kilometers. Then literacy rate was calculated with a formula of total number of literate person over total population excluding non-school going below the 5 year age multiplied by 100. And cropping intensity was calculated with total crop area over net cultivated area multiplied by 100. Next is to ascertain the human labor availability in Punjab agriculture from the year 1961 to 2011. The percentage share of cultivators, agriculture laborers and agriculture workforce were worked out. The percentage share of cultivators in total agriculture workforce was calculated through total cultivators over total agriculture workforce multiplied by 100, and the share of agriculture labor in total agriculture workforce was calculated through total agriculture labor over total agriculture workforce multiplied by 100, and share of agriculture workers in total workforce was calculated through total agriculture workforce over total workforce multiplied by 100. Then the share of cultivators in total workforce was calculated through total cultivators over total workforce multiplied by 100. Share of agriculture labor in total workforce was calculated through total agriculture labor over total workforce multiplied by 100, and the relative change was calculated through base year figure minus current year figure over base year figure multiplied by 100, and various model cost and standard cost was calculated for the total cost. And total cost is equal to total working capital cost plus total fixed cost. For the objective factors affecting demand for labor, power levels production function was used, and the estimation form of cost level production function becomes like this, and thereby it was to human labor. X1 is equals to hired labor charges, X2 is equals to cost of machinery use, and X3 is farm size, X4 is annual family annual income, X5 is size of family labor, X6 is cropping intensity, and we arrow down. And the best of the function was determined on the basis of the level of significance of the explanatory variables and the value of coefficient of multiple determination.
Where you are showing the changes in the current period over the base period. Just to have a slide for the call. करंट फिगर करंट फिगर माइनस दी बेस फिगर डिवाइड बाय बेस ईयर नीचे वाला तो ठीक है न्यूमरेटर जो है दैट सीम्स टू बी रॉन्ग आई थिंक इट शुड बी द करंट फिगर बिकॉज़ द करंट दैट इज इन एग्रीकल्चर प्रोडक्शन और न्यू इज द यूज ऑफ द बिगर दैट माइ दैट डजंट मैटर वेदर दैट इज इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज बट वी हैव टू एस्टीमेट द चेंज इन द करंट पीरियड ओवर द बेस पीरियड तो फार्मूला शुड बी करंट फिगर माइनस बेस ईयर फिगर डिवाइड बाय बेस ईयर होगा आपने
And the various statements were measured on 5-point Likert scale with scales such as first for strongly, one for strongly agree and two for agree, three for neutral, four for disagree and five for strongly disagree. So next is the result and discussion chapter and my result and discussion is divided into different sections. So the first section consists of detail of the sample villages or the socio-economic profile of sample farmers and villagers. So table 4.1 shows the gender-wise population in sample villages of Punjab and according to the table, among four sample villages of zone 1, Mutia was the smallest village. 2513 population, wherein male accounted for 55.17% compared to 44.83% of female. Moreover, male population to female in the village clearly reduced lower sex ratio of 813 females against 1000 males. And in terms of population, Sehri village was highly populated with nearly 1500 people, and in this village too the sex ratio is not in the favor of females, so as their proportion in the whole was 45.95% against 54.05% of males. In zone 2 among 4 villages, Kerempur was the smallest village comprising 1135 population in which males accounted for 51.54% in comparison to 48.46% of females. However, the proportion of males to females in this village clearly shows so low sex ratio of 940 females against 1000 males. And in terms of population, Oyam Sampal village was highly populated, comprising 2,940 people, wherein males accounted 50.78% compared to 49.22% females. And further, this village has the highest sex ratio of 969. And in zone 3, Jaipur Romana was the smallest village among the four villages and comprising of 2,348 population, whereas male accounted for 51.75% in comparison to 48.25% female. Well, however, this village has second highest sex ratio of 933 in comparison to 1,252, which is the Yatri village. Next is the social.
One minute, ma'am. It's a slide. I think there is some mistake again here in this. The as far as the last two columns are concerned, saturation as well as the density. Your saturation have horizontal say against the row subtotal. You have shown here for zone 1 horizontal say it is 862. Okay? The finally checked the figure, it is 862, that is the saturation. Then against the average you are writing 863. So isme thoda ambiguity hai. I think there is no need to write against the subtotal, you write only the average. ठीक है? Subtotal के against यहाँ पर against the saturation लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है, otherwise जैसे giving something difference 862 similarly if you go to zone 3 against the subtotal you see there is a difference 958 957. Then again in zone 3 again in the subtotal and average you find 968 969. वहाँ पर बराबर है आपका, तो there is a कैलकुलेशन में एरर भी है इसमें, तो सब टोटल के अगेंस्ट यू डोंट राइट एनीथिंग. तो यहाँ पे आप डैश लगाएं यहाँ पे, सो दैट इट डज नॉट क्रिएट मिसलीडिंग सम सॉर्ट ऑफ मिसलीडिंग टाइप ऑफ देयर एक्सरसाइज, क्योंकि आपको एवरेज के हिसाब से देखना है आपको कि व्हाट इज द एवरेज इन जोन 1 जोन 2 एंड जोन 3. सिमिलरली अगेंस्ट द डेंसिटी पर पर्सन पर स्क्वायर किलोमीटर इफ यू सी नाउ द अगेंस्ट द सब टोटल यू हैव मेड. आप देखिए आप इसमें जोन 1 में आपने क्या किया है, अगेन दिस सब टोटल दिस इज 574.91 और नीचे 539.61 आ रहा है. आई डोंट नो व्हाट यू हैव डन हियर. सिमिलरली अगेन दिस जोन 2 में अगेन दिस सब टोटल यू हैव एडेड ऑल द पीपल, ये 1200 715 686 जो जोड़ करके थे यू आर रिटर्न 571.67 एंड देन नीचे 5 क्या कर दिया ये. और नीचे ये जोन 3 में अगेन दिस सब टोटल यू सी यहाँ पर आपका 312 आ रहा है. मुझे समझ रही है डन समथिंग एंड इन समझ रही है डन समथिंग. आई थिंक दिस शुड बी ओनली द एवरेज एंड डोंट गिव इट फॉर द सब टोटल इन द सेक्स रेशियो एज वेल इन द डेंसिटी. हमें को मेरे को लग रही है आज ये नोट करते जाओ साथ साथ में, जो भी आप बड़े बड़े स्क्रीन के ऊपर जो है कि गो वेरी क्रिटिकली देन वी फाइंड अगेन द मिस्टेक्स गो आई अदर रेड द योर दिस इज बाय प्राइस बट देयर आर स्टिल मिस्टेक्स आर देयर एंड आई हैव ask you to check this one very critically कि ये density per person kilometer जो square है दस्ते चाल है, is it so in the Punjab the density is so high, this is the density per village ना per kilometer square, it might be respect sir, this is seems to be higher than the national average.
There is a lot of population migrated from other states, so it may be correct.
क्योंकि दसा जैसे जोन वन में माना 540 के करीब आ रहा है, जोन टू में जो है वो डेंसिटी आ रही है 51 और जोन थ्री में जाकर करके गेन 312 है करीब. जोन थ्री आपका वो ये नीचे वाला पटियाला पटियाला वाला एरिया पड़ रहा है आई थिंक जोन थ्री पटियाला वाला, और ओवरऑल जो आ रही है 434 के करीब आ रही है इसमें. इसको करेक्ट करना पड़ेगा ये. चलिए आगे मैं और से भी रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि जो कहानी है इसको क्रिटिकली एग्जामिन करें सारे, क्योंकि इसमें कई बार मिस्टेक्स ना फीसिस मराई जाती है एंड एग्जामिनर जो पॉइंट आउट लेट लो. तो चलिए आगे
नेक्स्ट टेबल इज द सोशल डेमोग्राफिक प्रोफाइल ऑफ सैंपल फार्मर एंड अक्रॉस फार्म कैटेगरीज. इट वाज फाउंड दैट स्मॉल एंड मीडियम फार्मर्स मे एक्चुअली बिलोंग टू द एज ग्रुप ऑफ 41 टू 60 इयर्स पर्टिकुलरली इन जोन 1 एंड जोन 3. Whereas large categories have a concern where farms young across the farm in zone 3 and zone 3, while in zone 1 large farmers have a big group of above 60 years. And in table 4.2a, revealing that majority of the sample head house, head of household belongs to the age group of 41 to 16 years, and the highest percentage was recorded in zone 3 followed by zone 1 and zone 3. And It can be said that farming population belongs to the old age group, and the young people, they are not taking interest in farming. Rather, young generation have seen and done research when they were in abroad. And in case of educational level, the level shows that majority of the small farmer possess education up to matriculation in all the selected zones. And while in zone 1, majority of medium and large farmers were illiterate, and in zone 2 and 3, majority of medium and large farmers possess education up to matriculation. And table 4.3 shows that at the overall level, the literacy rate among the farmers in 3 zones was 52.08%. Who have possessed their matriculation, and the result revealed that literacy rate was the highest in zone 3, followed by zone 2 and 1. So the literacy rate is great among the majority of the sample respondents, and farmers have possessed at least matriculation in all the 3 zones. Next is the family structure, and the family structure of the selected sample farmers in Bihar and Bihar was examined keeping in view the type of family. And according to the table, the medium farmers of zone 2 and small farmers of zone 3 were found living in the family, and all the farmers of zone 1 small and large farmers of zone 2, while medium and large farmers of zone 3 suffered a joint sample system. And in table 4.28, majority of sample respondents have joint families in the three days, and the highest percentage was recorded in zone 1, followed by zone 2 and zone 3. And the overall figure shows that 65.28% of the sample respondents belongs to the joint families, and only 34.72% of the sample respondents belongs to the nuclear family. The next is the occupation. People in rural areas generally engage themselves with more than one occupation to get income supplemented. So, farmers are not only dependent on farming, they are engaged in other subsidiary occupations to raise their income level, and majority of small and medium farmers will engage in farming in zone 1 or zone 2 and zone 3, while 15% of the large farmers in zone 1 will engage in dairy and poultry reports, and the majority of large farmers in zone 2 and zone 3 will engage in farming. And according to table 4.28, overall 63.37% of the farmers were engaged in farming, and the highest proportion was recorded in zone 3, followed by zone 2 and zone 1. And after farming, majority of farmers were engaged in dairy and poultry business. Next is the farming experience. And across farms, majority of farmers in zone 1 and zone 3 had 21 to 40 years of experience in farming, but a large farmer in zone 3 had experience up to 21 to 40 years, and more than 40 years of experience in farming by 33.23% each in the mentioned foods. Then table 4.28 indicates that majority of the sample farmers have 21 to 40 years of experience in farming in zone 1 and zone 3, while in zone 3, majority have up to 20 years of experience in farming, and overall, most of the sample respondents have farming experience of 21 to 40 years. Next is the family annual income, and in case of the family annual income across farm categories, it was found that most of the sample households were earning more than 9 lakh per annum in zone 1, and in zone 2, 25% each of the sample farmers were earning 3 to 5 lakh, 7 to 9 lakh, and above 9 lakh, while majority of medium and large farmers were earning above 9 lakh. and in zone 3, 35% of this non-farmers were earning 7 to 9 lakhs, whereas median farmers and large farmers were earning more than 9 lakhs. And in 4.28, a table, it shows that 62.50% of the sample respondents in zone 2 earned an annual income of more than 9 lakhs, followed by zone 1 and zone 3. And the whole 53.47% of the sample respondents and the annual income of more than 9 lakhs. Next is the social social demographic profile of the head of local household. Depicts that most of the central head of the family from the age of 31 to 40 years, and it was highest in zone 1, followed by zone 3 and zone 2. The overall proportion in the same years was found. 37.50%, and agriculture labor proportion mainly belongs to the young and highly productive places. So we are categories in this from one state and another in search of seasonal job. And next is the educational status, and the extent of literacy was maximum in zone 3, followed by zone 1 and zone 2, and the result at the overall level was that 56.88% of the sample level head of household was visited. So literacy rate among the majority of the sample and next is the nature of job. The result indicated by the study in the study area, around 61% of the sample respondents were casual laborers, and the proportion of this category varied from 43.75% in zone 3 to as high as 79.17% in zone 1. Next is the work experience, and the result indicated that in around 45.83% of the respondents had experience of 11 to 20 years in zone 1 as an agriculture labor, and most of the sample respondents in zone 2 had experience of less than 10 years, and in zone 3, 58.3% of the sample respondents had experience of more than 30 years. And overall, the agricultural laborers have experience of more than 30 years. Next is the family annual income. And the results show that most of the sample labor families are earning 2 to 10 lakhs income per annum. And the highest proportion of respondents earning annual income in the range of 2 to 4 lakhs, which was recorded in zone 3, followed by zone 2 and zone 1. So overall, the agricultural labor belongs to the young age group of 31 to 40 years, which has the potential to migrate to Germany, and the literacy among them is both at the level. Besides, they perform casual labor service and have experience of more than 30 years. Next section is the human labor availability in Punjab agriculture. And the table 4.4 shows the general growth of agriculture workforce in Punjab. And according to this table, total workforce in Punjab state was 34.66 lakhs, out of which 19.37 lakhs are dependent on agriculture and allied activities. In 1961, which increased to 98.97 lakh numbers, and out of which 35.23 lakh were found dependent on agriculture and allied activities in 2007. Also, around 56% of the total workforce in 1961 want to depend on agriculture, which includes poor farmers and agriculture leaders, and which begins to protect its person as well as being to fight the legislative consensus. And alpha paper was both the professional figure of farmers for the operation in 1961, which decreased to 54.93% in 2011, wherein the agriculture labor proportion increased from 17.87% in 1961 to 45.08% in 2010. Next, say 4.5 years of the capital changes demand for agriculture and this, according to the papers, overall the negative change was recorded in case of agriculture households and the positive change was recorded. It's a household dependent on labor, permanent labor employed by the household, and casual labor employed by the household. And table 4.5 didn't show that there is increasing demand for agriculture labor. And according to the table, overall negative change was recorded in agriculture household dependent on labor, and casual labor employed by the household. And the positive change was recorded from the area to positive age to positive age. Next is the table 4.5C, which is the temporary changes in demand for agriculture. And according to the table, negative change was recorded in case of agriculture household and household dependency level, whereas positive change was recorded in case of permanent labor. Not only this, there has been declaration in the number of households depending on labor, and at the overall level, the decline was noticed to be around 4%, and again, this reduction was one of the highest of 25% in June 2. In terms of permanent labor employment, services came to the extent of 24.51% was recorded in Punjab, and it was highest of 30.42% in Zone 1, followed by 22.39% in Zone 3 and 15.56% in Zone 2. And the findings are the belief that there has been increase in casual labor being raised by the couple household in Zone 5 and Zone 3. However, Zone 2 has exhibited the decline in the number of calculator, likely due to the sharp decline in the household by 22.27% and of the household depending on people by 25%. Next table is 4.6, which is the labor mobilization pattern of some of the simple harm. The table shows that the use of temporary labor is reduced in case of all the work of employment for 3 days, particularly during sowing, farm planting and harvesting season was highest on all the farms it was done, and permanent labor was found employed by different categories of farm in zone 1, in zone 2. However, its proportion across the farm and it was very low. And in absolute terms, the use of labor units by farm provided 265 mandate waiver at the city of Denver, family waiver accounted for 265 mandates across all the counties in the district. Next waiver is the state and six states because most of the farmers were hiring temporary waivers of this for different farm operations to the extent of 1,054 mandates. And in case of permanent waiver, there is a special update to form 866 Why are they competing agriculture users? And the results presented in the paper indicated that the priority level is a agriculture response. All the students they got is the one for building the large of it. This is a special update from the 95.83% of the also, the failure within that from the perspective of work availability from the labor point of view, if they stay for a longer duration in Zone 2, this might be due to the reason that Zone 3 was also given to the government and require more labor for swimming harvesting. And in some, the majority of central agriculture workers could avail employment opportunity just for 4 to 6 months, and that were ranging from 21 to 30 days in a month. There is a opportunity for more than 3 hours. Next section is the factors affecting demand for human labor. So, the main value and range of the selected variables, such as higher labor charges, farm size, household handle income, and cropping intensity and human labor use in the production construction analysis and the selection of variables based on scale. And according to the table, overall the average size of land living on sample farm was 7.38 hectares. They made an annual overall expenditure on high labor to the extent of 3.84 lakhs. And on the other hand, the average annual household income of calculator was 17.20 lakhs, and the crossing intensity is to be estimated in the range of 100 to 120%. However, there was average was 112.19%, and the average usage of human labor in utilization stood at 1,010.94 members.
Madam Kamala, one minute, it's a very slow. ये जो सेकंड आपका थर्ड कॉलम है, यूनिट्स यहाँ लिखा हुआ है, इसको लिखना पड़ेगा, यूनिट्स पर फार्म है ये आपके. फॉर एग्जाम्पल से हायर लेबर चार्जेस जो है, हाउ मच दे आर बीन पेइंग इन लाख रुपीज पर फार्म. तो सिमिलरली व्हाट इज द एरिया पर फार्म, दिस इज इन हेक्टेयर, फैमिली इनकम हाउ मच दे आर डिराइविंग लाख रुपीज पर फार्म. तो यूनिट्स पर फार्म लिखना पड़ेगा इसको, नोट कर लो. चलो आगे.
Next is the table 4.9, which is the estimated parameters of crop level production function. And the crop level production function estimate for finally selected estimation variables like higher labor charges, farm size, family angle income, and cropping intensity are selected in table 4.9. And as evidence from the data that the production countries that get their data quite well, because overall about 97% of the association paper employment was specified by the selected experimental data labels in the model. The coefficient of high labor, farm size, and family income, and the income is statistically significant. However, the results of cropping intensity were opposite to the current expectations. Next is the section 4, which is labor utilization factor in different agricultural activities. And farm-wise minimum labor utilization in every calculation has been presented in table 4.10. And it can be noticed from the table that the labor used in every calculation was higher from all the farms in transplanting operations. And in this category of labor, usually the service of casual labor was system. And after transplanting human labor, human labor was intensively used for the application of irrigation water, which is the essential requirement as per the nature of the job. And in the application of irrigation water, generally fuel and canal sources were used. And most of mostly the family labor was on the higher side for this type of operation. And on table 4.10 also reveals that the human labor used for all farm operation of heavy varied from 43.019 days in small farm in zone 3 up to as much as 54.89 days per hectare in large farm category in zone 1. While the zonal basis, which is given in table 4.10k, it clearly, the table clearly shows that there was more per hectare use of human labor for paddy cultivation in zone 1 in comparison to zone 2 and zone 3. And in the study area as a whole, the current hectare labor utilization in paddy cultivation was arrived at 48.95 days. Next, table 4.11 contains the farm-wise information regarding labor utilization in cultivation. And the study revealed that the labor used in wheat cultivation was highest on all the farms for fertilizer application, and mainly family labor and government labor were involved in this farm operation. And after fertilizer, the human labor was intensively used for irrigation water and farm activities like land preparation, sowing sowing application of chemicals such as insecticides, pesticides, and herbicides as plant protector measures were the next important farm operation for which family labor was highly utilized. The permanent and casual labor was used for the family labor was highly utilized for the fertilizer and irrigation water. And for harvesting activities, the wheat for the harvesting activity of wheat was going to the campaign combine and qualified session in the final farm operation. So, casual labor was hired by the farmer for the operation. And table 4.1 indicates that human labor used for all farm operations for wheat varies from 15.89 days in small farms to as high as 19.59 days across farms. And the zone-wise human labor utilization in according to the survey for sowing and harvesting of potassium in the calcium and labeling for the soil, the higher use of calcium labels are what we need for harvesting of the potato crop. And if farm operation, live land, irrigation, fertilizer application, and application of insecticide, pesticide, based on the middle of presented in the table 4.14, the minimum labor is used for all the farm operations of the garden varies from 85.87 metric in small to 89.09 metric in medium and 93.76 metric in large farm category, and overall labor utilization in the garden cultivation was 89.57 metric. Comprising 87.85% of the calcium labor, which can be harvest as compared to family labor and community labor. Next section will be capitalization among agricultural labor sales in Punjab. So here I would like to explain what is capitalization. So, casualization of workforce is a process in which employment shifts from full-time and permanent position to as they will work for others in the farm and pay wages that are daily or yearly in nature. So, during life in migration of agriculture business from other states of India, especially from Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, has been presented in Table 3.15. And overall, majority of agriculture migrant laborers receive seasonal jobs. However, from Bihar state, this absolute number of 43,000 which reduced to 37 in 2013, and again increased to 42 in 2015. And on the other side, the agriculture migrant labor supply from Uttar Pradesh was remained static with 34 each in all the selected years. And so the majority of the agriculture migrant labor in Punjab had arrived from Bihar state in Zone 1 and Zone 3, while majority belongs to Uttar Pradesh in Zone 2. And Table 4.158 shows that overall there has been negative growth of 0.23% per annum in the supply of labor from Bihar, with no change in the supply of from Uttar Pradesh. And overall negative growth rate of 0.13% per annum for the supply of labor coming from the state, which may have an adverse implication in the agriculture. Next is the distribution of the sample agriculture labels from Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, and from village itself or nearby village, and their family members who are working as an agriculture labels has been presented in Table 4.16. And overall, majority of sample agriculture label households arrived from Bihar, followed by Punjab and Uttar Pradesh. However, in terms of number of labourers, the contribution came out to 51.28% from Bihar and 25.13% from Punjab and 23.59% from UP. And on the basis of the results, it can be said that Bihar state continues to be the major source of agriculture labor supply to Punjab. Next section consists of social economic problems.
Madam, I have a PC slide.
ये जो फर्स्ट वेयर द फर्स्ट सीरियल नंबर वी आर राइटिंग दी पंजाब लोकल फ्रॉम वेयर दीज एजुअल लेबरर्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम विद इन द विलेजेस आर फ्रॉम इंटीरियर पंजाब
फ्रॉम द विदिन द विलेजेस एंड नियर बाय विलेजेस
चलो बाद में करते हैं बात चलो आगे
नेक्स्ट सेक्शन इन पंजाब सो सीधी सेटिस्फेक्शन लेवल ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर लेबर्स इज इम्पोर्टेंट इन द लाइट ऑफ ग्रोइंग शॉर्टेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर लेबर्स ड्यूरिंग दिस सीजन And table 4.178 indicates that out of the total 48 sample respondents in zone 1, majority of them were satisfied with the regularity of employment, working hours, payment for work, timely payment, people desired the pay rates as compared to the other states, and kind of work expected. However, majority of the students have been dissatisfaction with this activity, less employment opportunities, particularly during off-season, and having less alternative source of employment and training with respect to the farm mechanization and incentive for work. And about other benefits, majority in zone by one, the neutral response followed by non-satisfaction for the free shelter, medical facility, and clothing, etc. Also, the majority of them were dissatisfied with extra incentive for recreation, birthday, and festival celebration, and sharing expenses on account of travel costs for major places, destination. Also, many large number of respondents were dissatisfied with the financial help offered to the family at the time of emergency when needed. However, majority expressed their satisfaction on account of people as well as property on housing. The next table 4.1b depicts that in zone 3, the participants expressed satisfaction for regular employment, working hours, payment for work, timely payment, getting the wages as compared to the other states, and kind of work expected. Whereas majority of study subjects were dissatisfied over training for operating modern machinery and incentive for work, and on asking about the less alternative source of employment, majority of them expressed neutral opinion. And majority of respondents expressed dissatisfaction on the free shelter, medical facility, and clothing, etc. And participants of zone 2 were dissatisfied with the incentive, extra incentive for recreation, birthday, and festival celebration, and sharing expenses on account of travel costs from major place to destination. And a good number of participants were satisfied with the financial help rendered to family at the time of emergency if needed. And the majority of respondents expressed the satisfaction on account of the pay and character of the honor household. Next table 4.17c shows that in zone 3, all the participants were satisfied with the regularity of employment, and the majority were satisfied with the working hours, payment for work, timely payment, taking this day's rate as compared to the other state, and work as per their choice. And majority of them remaining unemployed during off-season and having less alternative source of employment, whereas majority of migrant labor were dissatisfied with the training related to the farm mechanization and incentive for work, whereas majority of participants also showed dissatisfaction with the other benefits like free shelter, medical facility, and clothing, etc., and extra incentive for recreation, birthday, and festival celebration, and also for sharing expenses on account of travel costs and native from native place to destination. Also, all 1/3 participants will satisfy with the financial help received by them at the time of emergency when needed, and very high majority express overall satisfaction on account of people and character of the related gang members. The table 4.176 frequency of responses to satisfaction level of the total sample level response, and majority of the migrant eligibles were satisfied with respect to the availability of employment on regular basis. Majority of them were also satisfied with duration of the days they prefer work and regularity and on time. Being payment, and also a majority of participants expressed satisfaction for the base rate offered to them as compared to the other states and kind of work expected. However, a quite high proportion of migrant workers reported non-availability of work during off-season and having less alternative source of employment, and also failing with respect to the farm machinery operation and related incentive for work. And majority of participants also expressed dissatisfaction over other benefits like free shelter, medical facilities, clothing, etc., and extra incentive for the celebration birthday and festival celebration and sharing expense on account of travel costs from native place to destination. Also, more than 1/2 participants were found dissatisfied over financial help rendered to the family at the time of emergency when needed. And the majority on the whole satisfied with the and character of their honor household. And the result presented in the table 4.18 indicates that 4.188 that in zone 1, majority of the study subjects agreed on the non-availability of labor, inadequate supply of labor, costly labor, and lack of market access from their adequate demand for labor can be met at the time of need. And lack of trust to government, and breaking up the social boundaries, and demand for extra incentives by the labor, and demand for additional incentives like milk from the household, dairy and electricity and drinking water at the free of cost. And maximum of the sample farmers produced a little response on the poor labor productivity, lack of skilled laborers, and labor with an advanced emission level away, and lack of permanent labor. Table 4.18 indicated that in zone 2, majority of farmers agreed on the non-availability of labor, inadequate number of laborers, costly labor, lack of market facilities for their adequate number of labor can be hired at the time, at the crucial time, and lack of trustworthiness, breaking up social bindings, demand for extra incentives by the laborers, and demand for free of cost milk from the household, electricity, and drinking water. And maximum of the temporary farmers had a weaker response on low labor productivity and lack of free labor, and labor taking advantage of it away, and lack of permanent labors. Table 4.18C shows that in zone 3 also, majority of the farmer respondents agreed on the non-availability of labor, inadequate supply of labor, costly labor, and lack of market facilities of their required number of labor can be hired on the time of emergency, and the lack of trustworthiness, and the demand for additional incentives by the laborers, and demand for electricity and drinking water your thoughts. And majority of them disagreed about breaking up the social bindings and also they gave a neutral or a strong opinion on low labor productivity, lack of skilled laborers, and labor taking advance and government away, and a lack of permanent laborers. Table 4.18 reveals that majority of the farmers expressed that there has been long availability of labor during the time of need and inadequate supply of labor. So labor was costly and a lack of labor market from where they can gain the adequate number of labor at the time of need, and lack of trustworthiness and breaking of the social binding, demand for benefits and demand for milk from wholesale dairy, electricity and water on the free of cost. And maximum studies that have shown neutral attitude on lower labor productivity, lack of skilled laborers, and labor taking advance and then away, and lack of permanent laborers. Next is the summary and conclusion part. Around 56% of the total workforce in 1961 was dependent on agriculture, which includes both farmers and agriculture laborers, and this decreased to 36% in 2007. And out of the total workforce, the composition of farmers were around 83% in 1961, and this decreased to 54.93% in 2011. But the proportion of agricultural labor increased. It was 17.27 in 1961, and which increased to 45.08% in 2011. And over the last decade of 2008 to 2018, there has been fall in the agricultural household and the household dependent on labor. And this less dependent on labor might be due to the adoption of mechanized farming, and however, dependence on permanent labor today, it was grown and it was highest of 30.23%. In the prospects of work availability, majority of agricultural labor took away employment opportunity for 4 to 6 months, and that to ranging from 21 to 30 days in a month, and there they have to perform 2,008 hours. And the results of the factors affecting demand for the demand of human labor, the coefficient of five labor charges, farm size, and family annual income were statistically significant. And the results also exhibits that the cattle labor use was higher in case of paddy, sugarcane, cotton, tobacco cultivation, and of higher labor at the time of sowing and harvesting. But in case of wheat cultivation, family labor was on the higher side, and the casual labor was higher at the time of harvesting of the crop. Also, the majority of the agriculture migrant labor in Punjab arrived from Bihar state in Bhopal and Jhansi, whereas Uttar Pradesh had dominance in Jhansi. And the frequency of responses or the satisfaction level of sample respondents show that majority of the migrant laborers were satisfied with respect to the availability of employment, daily working duration, wage payment for work regularity, and payment on time, and getting good wage rate as compared to the other state, and kind of work expected. However, high proportion of migrant laborers reported the problem of unemployment during off-season, and also the training related to the farm machinery and that dissatisfied with the automated incentive program. And the majority of labor also achieved dissatisfaction with other benefits like free shelter, medical facility and clothing, etc. and extra incentive for recreation. And then birthday and festival celebration also sharing expenses on account of the travel costs from native to destination. And more than one half of the respondents were dissatisfied with the financial help rendered to the family at the time of emergency. Also majority, but the majority of respondents is overall satisfaction on account of birthday and charity working on the household. Next will be policy implication, and the sample farmer in the study area mainly belongs to the old age group, and young people are not taking interest in farming. So farming population is aging without any education garden by the replacement by the next generation. And the youth is likely to influence the growth of agriculture, and this can be converted into a huge income opportunity if the state has young farmers. And the state should draw some short-term, medium-term and long-term business plans to attract and encourage youth for commercial farming. And the literacy rate was good among the majority of sample farmers, that the majority of agricultural laborers were illiterate. So some efforts are needed to address such issues by giving trust on mobile seeds. Next is the agricultural labor comprised of young and highly productive people who arrive from different states in search of seasonal agriculture work. So there is need for more diverse agriculture, diverse labor-friendly employment plans for both migrants and local workers. And skill of agriculture labor should be improved for employability in the non-farm sector, and there is urgent need to start the short-term skill-oriented courses for enhancing their skill and make them employable. And on the basis of the data collected in year 2018-19, in the study area, majority of sample agricultural laborers did avail employment opportunity just for 4 to 6 months and that ranging from 21 to 30 days in a month, where they had to perform duty for more than 8 hours. And the longer duration of working hours in this case of casual labor without much safety measures should also be a matter of concern for the government and policy makers. And since majority of labor population at full earning was found with the range of 2 to 4 lakh, and this clearly indicates that the wage rate and the total family earning are quite low, and there is significant difference in wage rate in agriculture and non-agricultural activities, and need to suitable measures to raise wage rate in agriculture sector, keeping in view the income rates of the agricultural laborers. And more produce-based agro-industries must be promoted, as in grain farmers have to travel more than 10 kilometers for the disposal of sugarcane in sugarcane industry. Also, these industries should be located in rural areas so that rural workers can work at a reasonable wage rate for an appropriate period of time while also benefiting the farming community. And majority of agricultural laborers in the study area remain unemployed during
the autumn. Madam, now you conclude it for the other sentences. Need not to read everything now. You have written so many things now, because now we have got the correction from the other audience as well.
The majority of the agricultural laborers remain unemployed during the off season, and there should be some plan like Manrega for the zone, and also some subsidiary occupation should be there for like dairy cultivation to increase their income, and government should provide some financial support to the farmers and farmers, and there should be the promotion of low cost machineries.
ठीक है, आप जितना वो तो पढ़ पढ़ करके बोल रहे हैं ना, आप आपको पूछा ना कि डायरेक्टली आप बताइए कि ओवरऑल व्हाट इज दी टैक्स ऑफ दिस थीसिस और व्हाट इज दी ओवरऑल मेनी ऑफ आवर
सजेशन
कमिंग फ्रॉम बट चाहे वो वुड यू लाइक टू से समथिंग
व्हाट प्लीज आई गॉट टू ऐड वन थिंग दैट मेनी ऑफ आवर सजेशंस और कंक्लूजंस नॉट कमिंग फ्रॉम आवर एनालिसिस दे जस्ट लिस्टेड फ्रॉम अदर सोर्सेस Manrekha, she has not discussed anywhere in the thesis, but now she is telling actually more employment and Manrekha. And moreover, I see that in thesis, many tables are missing. He discussed so many tables, but in thesis, these tables are not given anywhere. That you have to check, please.
Sir, I have discussed the main tables, and all the tables are already discussed in the, at the seminar at the departmental level.
Kamla, मैं और जो observe, I thought that there are lot of wordiness in your thesis. You are cut and paste. So you need not discuss all the figures. Just give the general trend. You need not discuss all the figures. You are discussing each and every figure. So you need not give all the figures. Just give the general trend. One can see from the table if you want to see any figure.
Madam Dhaliwal, would you like to say something? Madam Dhaliwal, she is also in Ludhiana these days and she is from Punjab. Madam Dhaliwal, I think.
Madam, offline here
again. Out of link, okay. Chal, would you like to say something else, sir? So, otherwise, after few corrections, I have noted that.
She has done a lot of. Lot of data she is collected, but it's very good study, but she has not shown from where the labor is coming from other states. She has not given any table on that aspect, from which state is coming, but in the conclusion she is telling that coming from Bihar, UP and other states. So,
sir, I have given that table.
Then given that table, okay then. Otherwise, it's a good study.
Sir, this is the table for the agriculture labor coming from outside and from the local village.
But Thisa, you have given lot of data. Where are the data? Give only main findings. So it will become more readable if you give discuss the just a general trend in the giving by table. But you give each, you need not give each and every figure. You give one or two figure, two three figures from each table, but not all the figures. So that making a problem with the readers.
So anyhow, sir, I have a few other observation noted from this thesis. So there are somewhere, Madam Kamla, we have to change the titles of the somewhere of the tables, and somewhere I find that the figures they must be uniformity by placing the decimal. In somewhere I find they still now the there are errors in placing the decimal. Somewhere you are giving one figure, somewhere it is a two figures. So again, some of the table need to be checked. In. I have noted down the number of the tables. So finally, after the seminar, you. Take this note from me. Then another is similarly in some of the other tables also. I find that there are some correct wording need to be given in some of the tables. And the good part of today's this is your seminar is that you have made very good slides and with highlighted with the different colors and properly adjusted in the space which is available.
And that too, this time you have managed timely. Otherwise, Dr. Chahal, what happened earlier, she was given a chance to present before the faculty of the department and she could deliver her that seminar in three different parts. One is on the 30th and on the 7th in two terms, that is the forenoon and the afternoon, because of the network issue. And then, but lot of the huge information was there in the thesis. But despite that, sir, I request Madam Kabila to kindly send a hard copy or maybe say the soft copy, whatever the Dr. Chahal.
Yes, sir, I have already received the copy. In my opinion, the seminar should not be extended beyond 45 minutes.
So, incorporating all those suggestions made by you.
That's why I'm reading the thesis. I will send in 2-3 days.
Okay. So, I thank all the other faculty members, those who have joined to us and saved their valuable time for almost 1.5 hours. And in absentia, I also thank Dr. B.S. Saul, otherwise he would have been there today, but we because of the problem, a technical problem in his laptop, so we could not enjoy his presence in this seminar. So, once again, if anyone is to say anything, anybody from the faculty, welcome sir, the presence of the Sharma-ji, Dr. Sharma-ji. Thank you very much, sir, for joining us. I have been in the beach.
I have a couple of things to say.
मैडम धनीवाल आप बंद कर दें वाला अपने वाला
हाँ जी जल्दी रखा
हाँ बंद कर दें थोड़ी देर के लिए बंद कर दें आप अपने वाला माइक
कमला थोड़ी ओके कमला थोड़ी बंद कर अपना
कमला हाँ जी हाँ जी बंद कर दो आप बोलें सर भाई
अब
नहीं सर वो फिर ख्याल में फिर कट गया ये
नेटवर्क की प्रॉब्लम है सर
आप ही प्रॉब्लम है सर ये बीच में ना नेटवर्क का काफी थोड़ा दिक्कत चल रहा
हेलो
हाँ बस बीच की में थोड़ी सी आ रही है सर बाकी आवाज नहीं आ रही सर हमें
मैंने अपना फुल वॉल्यूम तो रखा बोलने के लिए भी अदरवाइज
हाँ जी हाँ जी हाँ जी सर आप राइटिंग में दे दीजिएगा सर मेरे ख्याल में वो ठीक रहेगा
हाँ
हाँ बोलिए सर हाँ जी हाँ जी बीच बीच में करो तो समझ में जी हाँ जी
इनकंसिस्टेंसी इन प्रेजेंटेशन दैट मिस्टर को अपने पैट को किया
सर बिल्कुल आवाज थोड़ा पता नहीं चल रहा है हमें
थोड़ा इसी इम्प्लीकेशन
ओके सर हेलो हेलो हाँ जी सर
टू से any deposit toll. They have insurance of 2 lakh rupees for each another.
सर डॉक्टर शर्मा जी हमें ना आवाज नहीं आ रही है, बीच में बिल्कुल ही कटी आ रही है पूरी की पूरी। काई नहीं सर, आप नोट पे लिख करके भेज दीजिएगा सर, व्हाट्सएप पे इसे कर दिए अब स्टूडेंट को ही मैं देख लूंगा उसमें। देन आई विल ट्राई टू इनकॉर्पोरेट ऑल दोस से योर सजेशंस।
आपकी आवाज तो बिल्कुल आ रही है,
हाँ हमारी तरफ नहीं आ रही है सर, हमारी तरफ बिल्कुल नहीं आ रही इधर वो सर। तो काइंडली सर आप ऐसे करें, हाथ से लिख करके सर इसको व्हाट्सएप कर दें मैडम कपला को, भले जो इसमें भेजा होगा आपको सर, तो मैं सारा इनकार से कराऊंगा, जो भी होगा तो फोन पे आपसे डिस्कस कर लूंगा सर मैं।
पॉलिसी
हेलो हेलो हाँ जी सर,
हेलो
हेलो हाँ जी सर, फोन पे बात कर लूंगा सर इवनिंग आवर में आपसे, आपके भी लंच में बात कर लूंगा सर आपसे। डॉक्टर चाहे आप कुछ और कहना चाहेंगे?
नहीं ना सर, ओके फ्रॉम माय साइड इज ओके, फ्रॉम माय साइड इज ओके।
ठीक है सर, आई थैंक ऑल द मेंबर्स एंड द लार्ज अदर आउटसाइड द कमिटी मेंबर्स, इन पर्टिकुलर डॉक्टर चाहर मैडम धनीलाल सी आल्सो अवे फ्रॉम बड़ू साहब एंड डॉक्टर शर्मा जी आल्सो मैडम काजल काजल हु आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ द कमिटी एंड द आई आई थैंक ऑल द फैकल्टी मेंबर्स दोज हु हैव जॉइंड अस एंड द लार्ज स्टूडेंट्स, सो थैंक यू वेरी मच एंड आई एम श्योर यू दैट व्हाटएवर द सजेशन दोज विल बी कमिंग maybe say afterwards also, so those will be incorporated in our thesis. So thank you very much, sir.